This Black History Month, we celebrate Cumberland Posey, one of the best Black basketball players of the early 20th century and one of the architects of the Negro Baseball Leagues. In 1909, Posey played basketball as the first Black student athlete at Penn State. He played for 2 years, the first on the freshman squad, the second on varsity. He later played for Duquesne under an alias and led the team in scoring for 3 seasons. After college, Posey played baseball for the all-Black Homestead Grays. He ended his playing career by becoming the field and business manager, leading the team to success even through the Great Depression. Posey later became an officer of the new Negro National Leagues. Cumberland Posey died in 1946, and he is the first athlete to be enshrined in both the baseball and basketball halls of fame. So let's learn now about another pro athlete that's becoming a living business legend. New pro athletes are often encouraged to look at the end of their playing careers and ask, what's next? Junior Bridgman had that answer. Meet the man who was in the trade involving basketball icon Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
We are, I guess, forever linked in the trade that sent him from Milwaukee to Los Angeles, and myself and Elmore Smith and Brian Winters and Dave Myers from the Lakers to the Bucks. And a lot of people ask, were you disappointed in not playing for the Lakers? And I tell people, no, not at that time. You know, coming out of college, all you wanted to do was have an opportunity to play anywhere in the NBA. So even if they had stayed at a team in Anchorage, Alaska, you'd have gone there happily. So it was just an opportunity to play. And Milwaukee ended up being a great city for a number of reasons, career-wise and afterwards, so it's great how it worked out for everybody. Almost at the end of my basketball career, I got involved in the restaurant business, and the first restaurant was a Wendy's restaurant in Bedford-Stuyvesant, New York, in Brooklyn, of all places, and that was a tremendous learning education, and went from there and got involved in Milwaukee, and over 30 years, grew that company to about 450 restaurants, and have since gotten out of that business. And today, happily, I'm involved with Coca-Cola. We're a Coca-Cola bottler distributor, and the name of the company is Heartland Coca-Cola Bottling Company, located here in St. Louis in Kansas City, and we employ about 2,100 people and sell all different kinds of different brands of Coca-Cola, you know, Coke, Diet Coke, on and on. But there's so much more than just the carbonated beverages. When you get into the Powerades and the waters and coconut water and on and on. So it really is a comprehensive brand, and just happy to be a part of that, and providing refreshment to people in the Kansas City and Missouri and Illinois markets. I don't know if I really ever thought about a legacy or what you want your legacy to be. I mean, I think that you hope that when it's all said and done that you truly have helped someone else along the way, and you hope that you instill that same thought process and same way of looking at life to your kids. But yeah, you know, I don't think you want to have, you know, I'm not into having a building named after you or you know, having your name put up on something. I don't know what that does. I think that along the way, if someone could look at what you did and say, hey, look, he did it, so that means that I can do it, or I can do more than that. I think that's all that matters. Going forward, and as I said, helping someone, giving someone a helping hand along the way.
Thanks so much to Jonathan Davis for his beautiful work on that piece. If you want to get the secret sauce to Junior Bridgman's success, just head to heartlandcoca-cola.com and click on the About link. I want to thank producer Tom and producer Peggy Plyman for helping make this the best Black History Month ever for me. I hope it was for you too. Just make sure to keep learning and making Black history all year long. To do that, we need you guys to stay safe out there. So let's take another look from our Woods Basement System Storm Runner. Northbound 55, just past the Peevely exit, we do have MoDOT trucks on the road, so make sure you give them lots of space to do their work.